What's going on, gentlemen? What's going on? What's going on? What's going on? Shalom Aleichem. Peace be upon you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. It's your brother, Uncle K. You already know what time it is, and you already know how we coming. Like the video down below. Before we get into the video, if you're a returning supporter, I really appreciate you for tuning into the videos. And if you're watching the video right now and you're not a supporter, become a supporter right now and tell a friend, tell a friend, tell a friend. Gentlemen, this is about to be an important discussion because I feel like every man needs to hear this. Now, we're talking about self-control and discipline, of course, because each man need to know how to harness his sexual energy, and each man need to know how to walk in the righteousness of the Most High. You see, a man that lacks self-control, he lacks all control in all other departments. You see, when you give up your eye gates, you give up your heart. And when you give up your heart, you give up your mind. I'm giving you all the gem right now. Now, for the gentleman that may not know me or may not have been on this platform for a long time, I have been married over a year right now. Right now, I have a child coming on the way. Use the seed for procreation and don't use it to spill in a sheet, a sock, or a napkin, or vice, or whatever you're doing. Just, you know how to use the seed properly. It's okay to have sex every once in a while, but you gotta know how to have discipline. It's just like working out in the gym. You need time to heal and recover. It's not something that you do on a day-to-day basis. And especially if you have something important to do, like building a business, building your body, cleaning your house, building your house, doing something of edification that's gonna take you to the next level, you need to know how to harness this energy, because this is a God's given gift to all men, and all men lack the knowledge thereof. Now, scripture also says, right, in Proverbs, take on the wife of thy youth, smother yourself in her love, smother thyself in her breast. But my son, do not embrace the bosom of an adulteress. You see, a lot of men go bananas when they see an ass walking by. See, a lot of men are so drawn to the ass. Look at your history. The ass is the most filthiest part of the body. Now, what man will want to see their mother with their ass out all in the street, looking at the most filthiest body part on the body? I'm not here to condemn any woman. I'm not here to condemn any man that like a nice ass. Because if your wife have a nice ass but she's covered up, that's on you. You feel me? We love the woman's body, especially if it's under a covenant. But we don't embrace the bosom of an adulterous woman. We do not embrace the adulterous woman at all. And you must look ways to spot strange women. Strange women reveal. Now, if men, if 99.9% of men were walking around like untamed gorillas, they would have all their females in check. All their females would be submissive. You see, the man must be in his primal instinct. He must have that high testosterone. You must have that good DHT so you could grow that beard. You know what I mean? Get that muscle mass. Start getting chiseled. Start hitting some shoulders. But sometimes the man is too caught up with the bosom. He's too caught up with the body of a woman. It's so distracting. I can give y'all an example of something that happened to me yesterday. I wanted to go into the gym for 20 minutes and get a little quick little chest workout, quick little shoulder workout, because, you know, I had to go in and out. I had some things to do. As I'm finishing my workout, I go over to bang out some shoulders. I pick up the 80-pound barbell, throw it over my shoulders. As soon as I did that, right, my first set, I dropped the weight down, just chilling, deep breathing, a little sip of some cold water. This woman comes right in front of the mirror, looking at her backside with the weights in her hand, with a bunch of men in front of her, though. You get me? Like, she the one woman in the mirror in the back doing all this type of activity. And that's just all attention. And I tell y'all, gentlemen, when y'all moving in righteousness, when y'all holding on to this light, this abundance of light of that the Most High has given us, when you holding on to something that can create another life, do you know how much power you are holding on to? My mans, do you know how much power you are holding on to? So a lot of different type of energies flock to you. maybe like 2 years ago, I had this lady. She was like, man, I never had chocolate before. I never had a man that was holding on to this light. And she told me straight in her face that she was a Jezebel. Jezebels want to drain you. Trust and believe it. They want to drain you to the T. They want to drain your tea. And then they want to give you a nice glass of tea so you can go to sleep. And if I'm saying facts, let me get a facts in the comment section. If you made it to 5 minutes and 37 seconds, let me get a facts in the community. Let me get a facts. Let me get a facts down there in the comment section. Because every man knows for a fact, when you lose your seed, you lose a part of you. But when you procreate, you feel the bliss, you feel the connection. Because when you have sex, when you make love to your wife, and it's in the covenant, you increase spiritually. You may feel a little something gone, but you're gonna feel stronger in the spirit because you came together with a woman you were supposed to come with. Can I get an amen? Can I get a hallelujah? Can I get a praise the Lord? And I'm looking thick right now, but I'm humble. It's quiet over here, so I'm getting my vitamin D. You see, but like, it's just a lot of men are not focused these days. That's why you must have self-control and discipline. You must have self-control and discernment because not every woman is a good woman. You know how much energy it takes to rewire a woman that has been tossed back and forth in the streets, that just wanted to run around in the streets? You know, when a woman see a man that's taking care of himself, that has morals, and spiritually, you have morals. You don't even have to say that you have morals. You just know that you have morals when them doors are closed. They could sense that coming off of you. That's why a lot of women do not approach men on semen retention. Unless you, deep within, don't have those morals, or you don't have that embedded inside of you. Those morals that the Most High God has embedded in every man to hold on to really write down and study. Sometimes you don't harness those things. You don't read his word enough to really let those words soak into you. You gotta love the Lord with all your heart, all your mind, all your soul. So that way when you walk past people, they can feel it coming off of you. So they have to come at you with respect because you're moving with integrity. You're moving with power. You're moving with authority. But a lot of men, they see something that looks captivating and they don't have. They do not have discernment. Because they think, okay, I made it right now. This is something I deserve. And then that woman stabs you right in your back. Drain your whole spiritual currency. And now you got to start all the way back. You don't want to be there. And for the fellas that's on them TV screens, that's on them. And when I say TV screens, I'm talking about them little TV screens. Y'all need to put them phones down sometimes. Y'all gotta be studying. Y'all gotta be doing something of edification. Because these cell phones drain you as well, or your energy. And half the time, the women y'all watching are fake too. Half the women y'all watching on the internet are fake too. They not even real. Y'all seen the video, the AI, right? The AI that has a whole bunch of followers, but she fake, Photoshop, artificial intelligent relationships. A lot of this stuff is fake, bro. And even if they got it enhanced, it's still fake, man. You gotta work for what you got. Real talk. The Lord gave everybody opportunity. You gotta work for it. But you need to know how to stay vigilant out here, man. Keep holding on for dear life, man. It's your brother, Uncle K. Shalom Elohim. Peace be upon you. Like the video, share the video, tell a friend, and shalom and peace, gentlemen.